This is Sheshachalam from Astro Guide Mysore. Today, let us talk on the planet Ketu. So, by this, we will be finishing initial introduction and a little bit of the significations of the planets, all the nine planets. Ketu, as you know, it is a sensitive point. It's also called as the dark planet or the shadow planet. It is the descending node, which is actually the intersection of the orbit of the moon to that of the orbit of the sun around Earth. So that is the orbit of the sun is called as the ecliptic or the grahana path. So Ketu represents two major significations. One signification is that aparajnana karaka. Paragnana means ihajnana, worldly knowledge. Aparajnana, knowledge either after this world, it is going into the realms of, after science, where the philosophy or, Puranas or Vedanta in particular is explaining, Upanishad, Vedantas, all these scriptural difficult texts to understand is represented by Ketu. And finally, after that, it also represents Moksha. Moksha Karaka. Now, explaining it one by one slowly. If a person has to achieve moksha, he has to slowly detach himself from the samsarika vastu. That is, he has to detach himself from the material comforts which actually are binding him to this world of samsara. So, the process of detachment is also seen by Ketu, which actually is also a karaka for sannyasa. So, as I had told you earlier, the chatur ashramas, the first two ashramas fall into the major six planets. The third ashrama falls with Saturn. And the fourth ashrama falls with Ketu. Rahu does not have any ashrama. It is spread over in the first two ashramas of the samsara, materialistic world. So, Ketu gives acute knowledge. The person who has Ketu can become very sharp, will have very good grasping power, will have very good memory power. So, hence, Ketu does not waste time. The person who has good memory power will only read once, will only watch once, will only listen once. So these type of people are called ekasandhi grahi. That means grahi. Grahi means the grahana shakti, who has the capacity to grasp knowledge. Ekasandhi grahi, only once, if he sees something, if he learns something, he will grasp it. That is Ketu. So these people are very sharp. Their mind is very sharp. Their IQ is very high. The problem here is that they are not practically materialistic. So that means they are not into the worldly, they don't dig for money, they don't earn for money, they don't run behind money, and hence they are not seen much in the public scene. These people don't want to be famous. We always in our native language of Kannada, we call these people as Yele Mare Kai. Means those fruits which are behind the leaves, you can't see them. You need to climb the tree up to these branches. Only then you may find those fruits which are behind the leaves. If it was, on the other side, that it can be easily visible, then people would have thrown a stone at least to make the fruit fall and eat it. But it is behind the leaf. You can't see, you can't make out. It's a camouflage. That is why Ketu is called Chitravarna. Chitravarna, variegated. So the chameleon comes and falls in this particular planet. Sarata, what we call as the chameleon in Sanskrit is Sarata, which comes and falls in this particular planet. The signification. So Ketu, in the positive side, is a well-to-do person who voluntarily wishes to go through hardships of Hatha Yoga slowly starts cutting down all the materialistic pleasures and comes to a point of meditation where he will go through the self-realization and then moksha. Now, imagine the negative Ketu. A person is subjected to hardships. He will go through lot of paucity of money. He will go through poverty. He will not have food to eat. He will not have cloth to wear. So all that the earlier stage the person has voluntarily left, this person does not have the elevation of the mind, but he does not get all these things. So he does not voluntarily leave them. It is not there for him. So he goes through all the hardships because his mind is not set for moksha, but Ketu is playing its role. That means when Ketu is negatively posited, a person may, you know, have to part with things which he loves, part with things which he wants, suddenly goes through losses. Something like, you know, the Bhuj earthquake which suddenly made a man standing outside his house. He is alive and the whole family collapsed and went 15, 16 feet deep under the ground. So he was like, you know, he was something 2 minutes ago and he is nothing after these 2 minutes. So this happens in Ketu. Ketu is a very, very, tough planet to analyze with regard to calamities of life. Accidents, fractures and many things have to be seen from Ketu which is not seen from any other planet. The biggest requirement for a person to get into meditation is to be in solitude. So Ketu represents solitude, it represents tranquility, it represents silence. But the negative part of it is that it represents loneliness, it represents homesickness, and it represents becoming mute, losing his voice. So earlier it was voluntarily that the person became silent. The negative is that he does not have the voice to speak. He wants to speak, but he doesn't have the voice. As the earlier part of it was, when it is negative, that there is a beggar who, if given the opportunity, would want to be as good as any middle class or a rich person wants to live the material way of life, but he doesn't get it. So Ketu gives either this or either that. It's nowhere in the middle. So it's icy cold and isolated, and it actually, Ketu is represented by the laser beams or the x-rays which actually go through us, pass through us. So all those treatments which require radiotherapy, laser therapy, X-ray as an investigation tool for understanding what is there inside, and then the therapies which are like LASIK, you know, the eye therapy through laser, the stone burnt through laser, so many things which we do which are non-invasive. All these things come under, all these treatments and all these diagnosis comes under Ketu. Keyhole surgery like laparoscopy and many other surgeries like angiograms, angioblast, angioplasty, and even inserting stents or going through catheters. You know, wherever you put a scope and try to do like endoscopy, all these things come under Ketu, wherein you are trying to do as much as less, you know, invasion, that is non-invasive, what we call. We don't cut through the person's body here much. So the other medical fields which we have to understand here is that the teeth which goes through cavity and porosity which happens in the bone, we call this osteoporosis. So this also happens because of lack of calcium or many other factors, but this has to be seen from Ketu and its position in the chart. So Ketu is like an obstruction to flow. It becomes a hurdle to a cause. and it becomes, a person becomes blank in any given situation. This is what is Ketu. So, obstruction to a cause is, for example, there is blood flow which is happening normally in the heart, and there is an obstruction like Rahu, which causes a clot, or it causes some fat or something to move and block one of the arteries, and there is a heart attack. So this heart attack is caused by Rahu as a primary cause, because it's only the fat which goes there and gets accumulated like the lipid. But the attack is caused because of flow of blood which is got restricted, and that is an heart attack. So if we go to the brain, the same thing happens and we get the seizures or the stroke, which happens because of the blood flow which has got suddenly interrupted. So it might be temporary, but still it happens. There is another problem which is very important from Ketu's point of view, is that it also interrupts the blood flow of the capillaries to the eye, the blood flow of the capillaries to the ear, all the sense organs. So if the blood flow is not good for the skin, there is a problem called as the vitiligo, which happens because of the, you know, depletion or death of the melanin pigments, or it's a malfunctioning because of paucity of good blood to the skin. So we get this white patches or whatever is known as vitiligo or leucoderma. There are many types of leucoderma, and all these are caused by Ketu. The one which is having, one which spreads very fast, is also because of Rahu and Jupiter's influence on it. So Moon, Mercury, Ketu, Rahu, Jupiter, all these planets have to be seen for leucoderma. I'm just giving you a hint. So going ahead, also problems of like blockages in the kidney or in the urinary tract is also because of the Ketu. So there are too many things which we have to see, you know, one by one. Even a nail which grows inside, no, inward nail growth in the toes, which will happen because of Ketu. The nail is represented by Moon, but the inward growth of it is because of Ketu. So all these things have to be very clearly understood. So let us go ahead and see the other parts. Now I have given you a detailed scope of Ketu and its role in the medical field. Now let me go to the other parts of human life. Like Ketu, when it is positively posited in a person's chart, would give nice polite behavior. It would not give a very rude behavior. Though this polite person, because of the Ketu's influence, is because of his behavior in outwardly, but inwardly he'll be very critical. So Ketu makes a person very critical on certain issues. So the color is ash white or variegated in the sense that it is like what I am wearing, or any multicolors in lines. That is what is variegated. You can go online and check what is variegated. So you get a lot of plants which are variegated. So the hypothesis and the theory which Ketu projects will be to the level of research. It's not easy to understand what Ketu talks, because it will be very cryptic and it will not be as simple as it is. So Ketu can become very good surgeons. They can go to very good levels of finesse in any of the engineering subjects, or doctors becoming in surgery or whatever. They can go to very high levels. They are the best in the skill. So they are good in meditation, yoga, orientation of the mind. The negative will be reversed now. They will never be able to meditate, because they will be impulsive and will have lot of challenges to sit in one place. They might have problems like becoming spastic or whatever. So there will be motor nerve neuro damages which may happen. This is the negative part. And silence, they cannot be silent if it is negatively posited, and orientation will become disorientation of the mind. So we need to see whether Ketu is well posited in the chart or not, because Rahu and Ketu are very important points which have to be analyzed in a chart. There are many theories which have come in recent years which actually have been expounded by many good astrologers, and there it's mentioned that rather than going into other planetary positions, first an astrologer has to see where Rahu and Ketu is posited in a chart. But the same thing has been hyped to the next level, where people are unnecessarily taking undue advantage of innocent people, like unnecessarily tagging them and their chart to have sarpadoshas because of Rahu, or Kala Sarpa Yoga because of Rahu Ketu's axis. All these things have to be first understood, and then you will understand. When I discuss about these things in the yogas, I will clearly explain what is Sarpadosha, what is Sarpa Yoga, what is Kala Sarpadosha, XYZ, and whether it is there or not in the epics. So I will go in detail so that you can easily understand whether in your chart it is there or not. Simply, you don't have to get fooled by many people who are there, you know. So stammering might happen if it is in the second or the third house. A person might even go for alms. Because the second house is the Annasthana. Ketu sitting in the second house is not recommended, as it is not good for Vakstana, Vani, and stammering, because it is in the tongue. Second house, tongue comes there. Stammering might happen even because of the vocal cords. It is in the third house, that is communication, Vakstana. So, foreign travel, foreign language, this is very important to understand. When Ketu is well posited along with Moon, because Moon represents languages, people can do very well in as a translator from one particular language to another language. I have seen charts of people who are translating two foreign languages wherein their mother tongue is something else. So they are proficient in two languages. They can, a person from India has learnt French and Japanese. Imagine the speed of the brain, that he has learned both these languages to the highest level, so that he is translating French to Japanese. So people can do this, provided their Ketu is well placed. So Ketu also represents snake bites, insect bite, poison, intake of poison or poison food. You know, sometimes it happens that we go to some functions or some places where the food is prepared in mass, and sometimes if there is some adulteration which happens, then food poisoning happens, and this food poisoning can cause a lot of damage, including the biological food poisoning which happens because of fecal matter getting mixed up in the food, and we get amebiosis. So this is also, diarrhea and amebiosis also falls under Ketu. So removal of an organ or amputation also falls under Ketu. That is, removal of an organ is a voluntary thing because of some problem or a disease or something, or amputation also is voluntarily done because some gangrene or something else has happened in the leg, and the doctor, advises the patient to go through amputation of one finger or two fingers or something in the leg, because it might spread or else. This is if Ketu is normally posited along with planets of disease. If Ketu is not normally posited, it is malefically posited. See, Ketu normally posited itself will give difficulty with the Rogasthana. If Ketu is posited with malefically in the Rogasthana, it might give accidents which might force the doctor to go through surgeries of amputation. So this is different now. Ayudha Prahara, that is, Ayudha is used to cut now. It is not that it happened voluntarily, that I go to the dentist, I sit there and ask him to pull out one of my teeth because it's decaying. That's a voluntary thing. Tooth decay is there. That is because of the Rogasthana. Some Roga is there. So I go and get it pulled out. That is different. meeting an with an accident head on and losing 4 or 5 teeth in the row, that is not good. So we need to see where Ketu is positioned, because I am giving you too many positive and negatives of Ketu. The positive of Ketu was that I went to the doctor, it was a tooth decay, and got it pulled out, and now I am relieved of the tooth pain because there is no more tooth there, and it has been, you know, suture has been put, and I have been given rest for a week, and after that I will not have a teeth, but still my functionality will be better. But the other way around is that the damage is severe when Ketu is badly posited with malefix, and then in the 8th or the 6th or the Rogasthana, we have to keep going ahead and understanding this. I am just giving you hints here, so please, all the doubts pertaining to placement of planets, you know, what happens when Saturn is here or what happens when Ketu is here, will be answered in due course. I will not answer them because this is a very basic level what I am teaching. So when I go to the higher levels, I will answer them. Okay. Okay. Starvation. This is one thing which Ketu shows prominently in a chart to a given region when we go for mundane astrology. Famine, you know, starvation is not the Sallekana method wherein, you know, the great Ashoka went to Shravanabelagola. He came to Shravanabelagola in Karnataka, where he actually had, you know, converted himself to Jainism, Jainism, or Buddhism. Yeah, I think it's Buddhism. So he came to Shravanabelagola and did the Sallekana method keep eating less every day, and slowly he will come to a position where his meditation will take over his body, and then he will go by himself. You know, it is like, you know, voluntarily walking out of the body. It is very tough. It is a very tough method. And one of my known Swamiji's in Karnataka, Swami Nirmalananda Swamiji, who was residing in the Bihar Hills, that is the Biligar Ranga Hills in the Chamrajnagar district of Karnataka, he went through this process of Sallekana method, and I have transacted with him. So he was a person who had left speaking for 20 years. The Ketu is so strong that he was under Mauna Acharana. That is, he stopped speaking to people for 20 long years. He was silent. He was not even uttering a sound. It is not that he would be acting like a person who doesn't have a voice and he would just give out sounds. No, he was not uttering even a sound for 20 long years, and I have seen that person personally, so I know him. So I know how a person would look when there is a strongest Ketu inside him. So starvation, voluntarily and involuntarily, I have explained, it is both because of Ketu. Breaking of marriages, ending up of relationships, this is one thing which I think is of utmost important as on date online, because people keep asking that whether my marriage will work, when will I achieve divorce, whether there is a second marriage. These questions, when we are answering, we will take Ketu into consideration to see whether a real break of the relationship has happened or not. So, breakages or going apart from each other can happen due to many different, issues. The reason might not be always that break in a marriage because of divorce. No, it might also happen that a person suddenly got, you know, a job in the Middle East, and he is going there. He has to leave the family because he cannot take his family there because of so many family reasons. Children might be studying in colleges or schools. They don't want to discontinue that particular place. So the wife and children will be in the native place in India, and he will alone go to somewhere in UAE, somewhere in Oman, somewhere in Sharjah, and many other countries also, not only Middle East. Particularly Ketu, because of Ketu, I told it's Middle East. So he'll go there, work for 5 years, you know, bread, butter, jam, and sleeping in a bunker. Who wants this life? But the force of earning money you know, the compulsion, the obligation to pay back the loans will have put this person on the journey to that particular place. You know, bread, jam and butter and sleeping in a bunker is like as good as putting a person in prison. But still, they endure all this. This is Ketu. They endure all this only to make ends meet. But anyway, retirement from profession, that is also a breakage, that you are leaving a company in which you were working for such a long period, and because you are 58 or 60, you are retiring. So you will tell thank you very much and you will come out of the company. So that is also there. Forced retirement, suspension, temporary suspension, and suddenly, you know, terminating an employee out of service also comes under Ketu. These are the negative parts of Ketu. Retiring from service after full completion of service is a very honored thing. You know, they send these employees with honor, send these officers with honor because they have done full service. Termination is because of some bad conduct. So termination suddenly asking him to forced retirement, that is happening nowadays in many places. And anyway, that is in government that they will force them to retire, but in private they'll just give a pink slip and tell, even they will not entertain that person to come inside the company. The pink slip will be there with the security near the gate of the company, and that slip will be handed over to him, and he will be asked to come and meet the HR on a such and date and finish his obligations and thank you very much. So this thank you very much is such a rude way of telling, and that is Ketu. You know, suddenly today morning I go to my job and my job is no more there in my hand. I'll have to search a new job. So this is happening in Bangalore on a daily basis. It is happening around the world on a daily basis. So people are under high stress and tension, and this is because of uncertainty, and this uncertainty is ruled by the planet Ketu, one of the planets. I'm not telling uncertainty is only ruled by Ketu. It is one of the planets which rules uncertainty. There is one more thing which is very important here, is fear OCD. Obsessive compulsive disorder because of fear that something might happen to me. So people, when many of the clients who call me will have this problem, you know, out of 100, at least 2 or 3 have this problem. You know, 3% is not a small number, that they call me up and they tell that I think I am going to get cancer. I don't know from where they suddenly get that message, you know, in the dream or in some bottle floating in the ocean. You know, the message in the bottle comes and knocks their leg and tells that you are going to get cancer tomorrow. I don't know what happens, what goes on in the mind, because I don't have such a Ketu. My Ketu is very strong and, you know, controversial, because I speak like this. So I'll tell you that Ketu is also controversial. If a person is preaching or talking like me, I sometimes might become controversial. I can go through subjects which are very dangerous. So, but anyway, people who call me with this type of mental disturbance, it is very difficult to convince them that nothing is going to happen, they are going to be fine. But every now and then, every 15 days once, they want a counseling, they'll call me up and ask, sir, I have a doubt, my husband has an affair. But after that, it stops there. They are worried, but I ask whether her husband is behaving abnormally. She tells no, he is fine. He comes home at the right time. Everything is fine, but still I feel that he has an affair. So now it is so difficult to go ahead, because there is nothing else we can check. Again, we need to check the horoscopes of the husband and the wife and then go through the details. But still, it is so difficult. So psychiatric or psychological counseling is required for these people who suffer from phobia. And all phobias, you know, people have phobia of snake, people have phobia of lizards, people have phobia of earthquakes. You know, one or two times maybe they have gone through that in their childhood, the tremors. And now they usually suddenly wake up at night, they feel that the house was trembling, shaking, and there was an earthquake. So this phobia has to, people can come out of it only with a psychological counseling. This is very difficult to solve, because it is by Ketu. It is anything given by Rahu and Ketu is not easy to simply wipe out and tell that I have walked away from it. It cannot happen. So, the extremities of Ketu, I told you that it can give blindness because it affects the blood flow to the eye. It can also give Karagraha Vasa. What is Karagraha Vasa? Karagraha means jail. A term in the jail. So, behind bars. So, it can give that too depending on the situation in the chart. So, that should not be directly said that, oh, 12th house, Ketu in the 12th house, you will go to jail. Nothing like that. Ketu represents the 12th house. Ketu is the Karaka for the 12th house. And I have seen many charts with 12th house Ketu. These people are more spiritually bent towards refinement, not going to the jail and getting refined. That is the negative part of Ketu. You know, going to solitude, sitting there and refining yourself is a different thing. Going to the jail is forcible. You are not going there for refinement. You are waiting when they will let you back out in the public. So, this is there. And there are many other things of Ketu which can be gone through in detail. But I think this is enough for the introduction of Ketu. Thank you very much.